relationship with Him first of all. And when you get that relationship with Him, everything else is going to fall in place. And as I come to a close this evening, in Matthew 16 and 19, it tells us that kingdom citizens are given keys to the kingdom of heaven for the purpose of defining and setting the proper environment in this earth realm. Anyone who possesses keys to the kingdom of heaven will only bind and loose those things that are beneficial to the kingdom, to God's kingdom. That kingdom is here on earth. We can have it here on earth. The many of you is looking at, well, I've got to die to get into the kingdom. No, you don't. Kingdom here on earth. God's kingdom. You're carrying it around with you. It's in you. Live it up. Stir it up. Get the word in you. Then you will know that the boldness that you have, that you can defeat Satan and anything else that comes against the word of God for your life. But what God has planned for you is for you. Right. You can have it now. You can have it today, not tomorrow. And you can have it in abundance. Because that's what God wants you to have. So, church, we have got to become more familiar with the meaning and the act of knowing how to bind and to loose things of this in this earthly realm. Chapter 18, verse 18 through 20 in Matthew tells us that we not only have the privilege to bind and to loose, but there is a guarantee given to all kingdom citizens. God, the creator of the universe, committed to being in the midst of things you and I, or any other kingdom citizen partner, or we come to an agreement to have, make things happen. God is there, but we don't stick to our agreement with one another. But we still want God to move. We want God to just move everything out of our way while we don't even make an attempt to come together to agree with one another to move it out of our own way. When we get ready to make things happen, those things will manifest here on earth, in this earth realm, that will benefit and enhance the kingdom of heaven. Philippians 3 declares to us, but our citizenship is in heaven. Goes on, I put in here that we can have heaven right here on earth. We don't have to wait until we say we're going to die because we don't know what's going to happen. Are we going to make it in? But if we begin to have heaven here on earth, we wouldn't even have to worry about making it into the kingdom. Because we are living that kingdom life right now. And we eagerly await a Savior from there, and the Lord Jesus Christ, who by the power that enables him to bring everything under his control, will transform our lowly bodies to that they will be like his glorious body. The national borders in which we live our lives on earth are the only passing importance in the grand schema of eternity. Right. Church, it is time for us to wake up. It is time for us to realize that the kingdom of God is within you. The kingdom of God is his dwelling place. When this old body, life leaves it, it's going back to the dust. But the spirit, where God resides, will be caught up with him. Then there's going to be church for day. But we want to be prepared. That we are prepared to be in the kingdom of God. My question to you again is, are we too busy for the kingdom? Are we too busy doing busy stuff that we cannot do kingdom business? We cannot go and seek and save those that are lost. We're too ashamed to say something to the person that's walking down the street. I know you say, well, they might jump you. But if you plead the blood of Jesus, you say, Jesus loves you. Then you put your angels on assignment. We have not learned how to dispatch the angels that God has assigned to us. The word says he has given us a legion of angels. But they are sitting waiting while every beck and call to give them an assignment. Let us be mindful. Let us get into the word. Let us get the word into us. Let us activate the word and let it have life within us. As I prepare to say my last few words, I just want to thank and praise God that he was with me today. I had quite a few attacks on yesterday. My voice went to leave me again this morning. But I thank and praise God that when we trust him and put him first, he's always there. He's always there. He will come through. He will be there to let you know. Whenever we put him first, may not leave us stranded. I thank and praise God for you all that set tenant to hear what thus said. But that we would put arm in arm and we would be strong. And we would not be so busy with ministry, but we would be busy with God's work. To go and to seek and to save those that are lost, that they will be a part of the kingdom of God. That they can have kingdom right here. Dear Lord, I thank you and I praise you for your word. Thank you, O God, that you are here in the midst. Thank you, dear Lord, that I've said what you've given me to say. So I say, have your way, Holy Spirit. Angels on assignment that has been assigned to each and every one of us. I give you authority to move by the power of an almighty God. Satan, let me speak to you and let you know and remind you that you have no place and we give you no place. Not only in this place here, in this brick and mortar, but in our personal lives, in our neighborhoods, in our homes, and in our street, in the streets where we live. We give you no place. You are defeating foe, and you are on the run. And we're going to keep you on the run in the name of Jesus, because the blood of Jesus is against you. Just as well as I am against you, knowing that what God has done for me, he can do for anyone else. He has delivered us, he has brought us thus far, and we are not to do that. So we thank you.